By twos. You want a hot belly full of pot liquor? Fall in by twos, I tell you. I'll teach you, Johnnies. What are you waiting for? Beefsteaks? You'll get a lead meatball, pig-headed Z Sessions. Had a fight like a band of gorillas when your war was over and lost.
You ain't won nothing, you ain't.
Who said that? Step forward if you got the guts.
It was me.
I'll ram that grin down your throat, Hammond, but I'm on duty here until I've fed you. Make it fast, all of you. That's an order.
Why's you feeding these slops?
Damn Yankee.
Let go of me!
Corporal, I'm right here.
Hey, Private, what's all the ruckus?
Oh, Corporal Wilson is waltzing with one of the Southerners.
Gary Hammond, I might have known it.
Oh. I'm one up, I reckon.
Leave your gun where it is, Wilson. Who started this?
I'll tell you, Sergeant. The rebel, that's who. Hit me when I wasn't looking.
I'll make a full report. Put it in writing, Corporal.
Yes, Sergeant.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant Hammond, but obviously...
The solitary cell. I know, Sergeant Pitt.
Hey, orderly.
Oh, he needn't bother. I'm acquainted with it.
I'll come eat breakfast here with you. If food is the reason for this.
Damn right it is.
Thanks, Sarge.
Get the hog down home.
Get these men another meal. And first of all, take a bath.
Yes, Sergeant.
Lieutenant McDonald.
He's in the wagon, sir. He's dead. There was an ambush in Crow's Pass. They attacked us on our way to the fort. Huh?
Southern guerrillas, eh?
Not these, sir. They were bandits of the Riggs gang. At least we managed to capture two of them.
Shoot the rascals.
Firing squad.
No! Don't shoot me! No! Let me go! I want to see the colonel! No! No! No, let me go! Don't shoot me!
Detail, fall in!
Detail ready, sir.
Proceed then.
Dismiss the firing squad.
As you say, Colonel.
Dismiss the detail.
Untie the prisoner and bring him into my office. I want to talk to him.
Take him to the Colonel's office.
Go on.
I've read the report written by Wilson. What was behind the spectacle you put on today?
Our rations were slapped for a pigsty.
Does that provide sufficient reason to hit Corporal Wilson?
No, Colonel. I only tried to keep from being hit.
Ah, quick thinking even when you answer questions. I admire that, Hammond.
Thank you. If that's what would have saved another person, the man who was shot here today.
He was a bandit, Hammond. You instead are a soldier, even if a Reb. Unless I'm mistaken, you commanded a company of Quantrill's raiders.
We gave you plenty of trouble. You haven't forgotten us, all right.
Yes, you fought bravely. You've had lots of experience in the West?
I was raised there.
Then it will be easy for you to find Fort Yuma.
Yes, sir. But what's the point of this interrogation? Colonel, let's not play around any further. Let's be frank. It's better that way.
All right, Hammond. There's still a regiment of your raiders that's not obeyed the order to give up its weapons. Well over 800 fanatics who cannot realize the South is defeated.
800 patriots,
outlaws for us. And General Lee shares our attitude toward such patriots.
I'm sure Lee'd share a different attitude if he could. You're hedging, Colonel. If you've come here in the middle of the night, it's certainly not for the pleasure of my company. Let's have it straight, huh?
I need a guard for Captain Lefebvre and Sergeant Pitt. They have to get through to Fort Yuma with the vital message.
What you need is a telegrapher.
Not with a line cut. The region is infested with guerrillas and bandits. But you could get through easily because it's your home.
Are you offering this to me, a rebel?
I know I can rely on you to help, since this mission will give you the chance to save the lives of the rest of the men in your regiment. All 800 of your men are preparing an attack on Fort Yuma.
Fort Yuma? That's suicide. They'll all be slaughtered.
Yes, they will. They've been led to think that the fort is undefended. But that's understandable. I've managed to find out from one of the outlaws that a band of criminals plan to slip in and steal the cash deposited there for the whole territory, $1 million. They intend to sacrifice the men of your regiment to distract the troops in the fort during the attack. That way they can get in through an abandoned mine shaft and steal the money.
Red mines. I know it. And the text of this vital message, sir?
I've ordered the commander of the fort to prepare for attack. On the condition that he not open fire unless your raiders attack him first. And it's up to you to convince your rebel friends not to fall into the trap.
Now, you mentioned a pair of criminals. Who are they?
Riggs, the boss of the outlaws, and no less than the commander of the guerrillas, a certain Major Sanders.
Sanders. Glad to do it, Colonel.
What's the matter? Every 100 yards, we stop dead in our tracks. I'm talking to you.
Oh, sorry, Captain. But I'd swear somebody's been following us ever since early last night.
You're getting a little ledgy. You afraid of ghosts, maybe, Reb, huh?
Not if you're here, Captain.
Let's get a move on.
Captain Lefebvre.
What is it?
Take a look over there.
Hey, Red. You see a ghost everywhere we look. What do you think is making all that dust?
Somebody's ghost on horseback. I'll find out.
No. I'll go look. You just stay here and keep Hammond under guard. He's a bit too edgy to my liking.
I'd say that Captain Lefebvre doesn't trust you.
I'd say that, Sergeant Pitt.
A swallow?
Thanks. And you, Pitt, do you trust me?
Maybe yes, maybe no, because you'll always be a Southerner. One of the worst of my way of thinking. With your hot head and your cannonball hands.
Just like a rabbit's wizen. I reckon it's obvious I won't try that with you ever again.
Ain't it pretty?
Yeah, it's pretty, all right.
At Gettysburg, this derringer in the hand of some rebel popinjay almost sent me straight to glory. If I don't come back, it's a present from me.
I'll bet our captain wouldn't quite go along with that.
You're right.
There's not a soul in sight. Let's move on.
Thank you.
to escape, huh?
Shh. Want to see?
Up with your hands, you skunks. Come on or I'll shoot.
Now, friend, tell me what's going on here.
What do you want?
You leave the questions to me. Your boss is that bandit Riggs. You got 3 seconds to explain why you followed us.
We was just obeying orders, but the person who gave them was Yuko.
Who's Yuko?
He's a partner of Riggs.
He must be the one who got away.
Drop that saber, Hammond.
What happened, Sergeant?
They're part of the Riggs gang, sir. That's who was following us. Hammond managed to trap him here. Well, one was too fast for us.
What's he told you?
I don't know anything. We was following you, but for what reason, I don't know. I swear I don't.
You recognize this, Sergeant?
Yes. That saber was Lieutenant McDonald's.
No, I swear. I don't know anything. I haven't done anything.
Execute this man.
No.
That's an order, Sergeant. We're in no position to carry along prisoners.
No, wait. I didn't do anything. No. Don't. Yuko made us follow him clear to Camp Davis, but I don't know why. I don't know, honest. No. No. No, let me go. I can't tell you nothing else. I can't. No.
They're the ones who killed Lieutenant McDonald. And now he's avenged.
From the commander.
But I've got a ticket. Listen, folks, unless you get a pass, you can't go. Hey, you get that stage moving.
Got it, Riggs. Here's the plan of Fort Yuma.
What happened to the other men?
They were all killed. We lost two of our men in the ambush. And then last night, the Yankees surprised us. Where's Sanders?
He'll be along.
Thank you.
Come here. Where's military headquarters?
Over there in the saloon.
In the saloon?
Out of business. No more girls, no whiskey, no piana. Just a bunch of militia.
Peace and sure hell.
Wait for me here.
I've told you three times. You've got to submit a declaration of war damages.
I submitted a declaration already. I want to know what happened to it.
It's the fourth time you've made me come here.
I'm sorry.
I don't answer to people. This is going too far.
Thanks a lot, Corporal.
Good morning. Has my pass been signed?
I can't rightly say, ma'am. Lieutenant Morris is taking care of your pass himself.
Morris? Oh, the tall boy.
That's him, ma'am.
Much obliged.
My pleasure.
This way, please, Captain.
Such a bright young officer, I should hope.
Why, thank you.
By now, I would have had my little pass signed.
The colonel has to sign it. But he will. I'm sure he'll sign it today. You must understand, he has many urgent problems to settle.
But does he think my problem isn't? I should be in Brighton now. If I'm not, I'll get fired. Tell the colonel he's costing me money.
I can't.
Is this colonel really such an ogre?
With me, he is.
Let me speak to him.
It's useless. He's pretty old. Poor man.
Getting to Brighton. He's not a pleasure jaunt these days, Captain. In fact, it's largely a matter of luck. At the most, I can give you an escort as far as the river.
Thank you, Colonel, but it won't be needed. I have two experienced men with me, and one is thoroughly familiar with the area. All I'm looking for is the latest information you have on the bandits and the guerrillas so that we can stay out of their way, sir.
But you're better informed than we are. Since the bandits or the rebels cut the telegraph.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Morris. What is it?
It's urgent, sir. A safe conduct for a poor woman who's ill. She has seven children. They're waiting in Brighton.
What? Seven children?
Yes, sir. They need their mother.
Is she that lovely girl over there? Well, Lieutenant?
Yes, she's the one, sir.
Hmm. Mother, eh?
There's mud in your eye.
Same to you, Sarge.
Don't get friendly because I offered you a beer. You're a darn sight wiser these days not to trust your own mother.
And your mother, when did you last see her?
When we put her in her coffin. And my father, he said, thank the good Lord, there's one woman less. But pretty soon he added, pity though, she was the best one of the lot.
Pablo, Pablito.
Be careful, lady.
Excuse me, cowboy, but I'm a little excited, you know. Pablo.
Si, senorita, here I am.
Look at this. Now, Pablo, how about that, huh?
Nombre de Dios. Qué mujer.
He bet that I'd be stranded here without a pass.
They sure don't know women. I'd bet the other way around.
It wasn't very easy.
A pretty girl like you could get anything.
You flatter me. You probably say so to all the women you know. And your name is?
Gary. And yours?
Mine. You must know mine. Where you been, cowboy?
Heart of hell.
All the same, I've got lots of friends, even down there. Didn't somebody mention Connie Breastful?
Mm-mm.
So, are your bright eyes lost?
No. It's obvious where they are.
Are you fresh? Mm. Say now. Careful, you might turn a girl's head.
Now, it's only a question of days, Riggs. I'd prefer you go yourself to Brighton. Supervise the work in the mine.
All right, Major Sanders. You and me are working hard to earn that $1 million. 200 or 300 men killed ain't much to pay.
I'm worried about that message they sent to Fort Yuma. It could ruin us.
Oh, don't worry, Major Sanders. That message will never get there, eh, Yuko?
Hold on. Wait now. Come on. Stand back. Stand back. Show your passes before boarding. Only those with passes from headquarters need apply. Stand back, folks. Stand back.
There are no more passengers. We got too much luggage on board. Can't you see?
But that's not fair.
Don't be so upset. We'll make room. That's all.
Out of my way.
Move us now.
This young lady has a safe conduct. She's getting in.
Well, that don't mean nothing to me.
I'll make it mean something.
Now, you just try that.
With your permission, Sergeant.
Amen.
Oh,
push it back.
My.
We found your place, Miss Connie.
Oh! Thank you.
So long, Connie.
So long, cowboy.
Get that stage moving!
Sergeant Pett.
There was a bit of confusion, sir, but we was forced to help out.
Come on. We gotta find shelter and get out of this sandstorm.
On the other side of that hill is a cabin. Follow me.
Hammond, if you try any tricks, I'll kill you like a dog.
That'd be a big mistake. You'd never find your way through this hellhole by yourself.
Come on, get moving.
Thank you.
I'd say you're clean enough, Captain. Recognize this pistol?
Huh?
A bequest to Sergeant Pitt. If I don't come back, it's present, he said. Those were his very words.
All right, it's yours. But put that thing away.
No, Captain. Give me that dispatch.
You'll get it yet, Hammond. Sooner or later, you'll end up with a back full of lead.
You might be right. But I think it's very unlikely you'll survive to see it.
You dirty...
Go!
Do now?
You're something splasher. Can any of y'all swim?
Not me.
No.
Looks like we're in a fix, though.
But we can't just sit out here all day.
Hey, look. There's someone coming.
It's Gary. He can help us.
Here's my safe conduct, Sergeant. It should be enough.
At your orders, Captain.
How many men in your squad?
Five, sir. And my men found the tracks of a rider headed west.
Brighton.
Probably Brighton. Unless he meant to join the Southern guerrillas or outlaws.
According to me, he's hell-bent for Brighton. I'm taking charge of your cavalry squad, Sergeant.
Cowboy. Always in the nick of time to save the farmer's daughter in distress, huh?
I'd save myself a bath if it wasn't for you. Brave lot of men you're with.
Hey, they're shooting at us. Get in the stage, Connie.
Hey, come back over here.
Give me your pistol.
But those are soldiers.
Yeah, they're shooting at me. Get this barge across the river.
Me do as I say. Inside your
Gary!
My compliments, sir.
That's one less rebel traitor.
Let's go.
Easy, boy. I'd say you look pretty peaked. Take it easy, youngster. There's still plenty of time for you to die.
Now, grit your teeth, son. There ain't nothing better for avoiding a case of gangrene. According to the engines, at least. You ready for it? As a visit to the dentist. Those engines teach us a lot.
They ate in the score.
Yell your head off. You'll feel better. Give us a tune if you like. I'll rustle up some coffee. It's my own recipe for making coffee. Afraid I'll have to learn you by word of mouth, but it ain't complicated.
Mix a clutch of coffee and water that's boiling. Let the mixture boil a mite longer. Drop in a horseshoe, and if the coffee don't float it, add a mite more coffee. Thank you, sir.
How far is it from here to Brighton?
Too far for you, because you're in no condition to make it.
I was just wondering.
A couple days' ride. What do you need from Brighton?
Oh, nothing. There's some business I have to settle, and... Wait, maybe I can trust you. You were on the rebel side, I reckon.
No, weren't my war. I had my war a good while ago, son. I fought in 48. Down Cherogorda, when we put the pepper on Santana's tail feathers.
I'm glad to hear that. You should know I'm on the Union side, in the 7th Missouri. I'm supposed to get a message through without delay to Fort Yuma. But the rebel guerrillas must have gotten wind of this. I know I'll never make it unless you help me get to Brighton.
Where is this message?
No. Afraid I'm not permitted to say.
I'll go, son. Reckon Lincoln wouldn't mind using a helper like me. At your orders, Captain, sir.
She's still in town. Look, Goldie, wait for me here.
You don't expect me to wait all night with my throat dry.
We happen to be on duty, Goldie.
That's right. Pull your rank on me. I always said, Goldie, stay out of this war. Don't get in it now, but it ain't in our bargain to die of thirst.
We'll drink later.
Just one beer to wet my whistle?
No. A beer.
Hey,
kind of answer I want. Say yes or no.
All right. No.
You won't go far with that answer. You have to change your tune, Missy. The girl ain't successful here unless she's got a man to help her along. I'm a rich man. I'll be richer before very long. Lots richer. See this place? I could buy it all if you want. Want to have it?
Let's talk more about it later on.
Hey.
Let me sing the tune you wanted.
Huh?
Me.
Why should I?
To see if you're real.
You think I was a ghost or something? Hoopla.
No, I know you're real. From what you do to me. Sit me down or I'll faint. Can you wait for me, huh? Afterwards, I'll be all yours.
I'll be waiting. And that dude at the table with you, does he mind?
Spying on me, I see.
That's about it.
Just a guy I have to entertain. It's business.
The business he'll soon be missing. Where are your valises?
Aren't you rushing things?
Yeah, I am, Connie. But not the reason you believe. Where are your duds, huh?
If you want my bag, would you kindly tell me for what?
On the river a minute before I got shot, I hid a letter in one of your valises. An important message, Connie.
And more than 1,000 lives depend on that message. I've come for it now. I'm obliged to.
Mommy, you had a good time, honey. I know I haven't. Find a room at the hotel where I stay.
But
see you there.
Just smile and keep walking. And mind how you move, friend. That's enough, friend. Put up your hands and come here. I said come here. Connie Breathful?
Right, Grandpa. Who might you be?
Well, never mind. Now, look here. Ain't you been seeing Gary Hammond?
That's none of your business.
Somebody I fish out of the creek is my business, all right. Now he's as bad off as before.
What do you mean?
5 gunmen captured him and took him to King Rocks.
King Rocks? To Riggs?
Did Gary mention a certain dispatch to you?
It's somewhere in my luggage. All right, Grandpa, come on.
Grandpa, you're forgetting. That's no military dispatch. They're bloomers. If it isn't in those things, it's
there. Well, it sure ain't, but what are we doing then, if it ain't here?
I searched here, down to my shoes. Wait. There was a satchel.
What?
On top of the stage. Now, just a second. Something's here. Is this it?
Officer, Fort Yuma, 1st Brigade.
At your orders, Captain, sir.
But there's some mistake. You got me crossed to somebody else.
No. You're the man, all right. You're running a big risk if you're thinking I ever make mistakes.
I got that impression last night. And don't think I envy heroes.
At least hear that, boy. I warn you, it'll be a sad day if that dispatch is delivered.
What's your interest?
It's in all of our interest, Hammond. Yours, most of all. I'll take over for a spell. You weren't expecting me, were you?
You said it, Captain. Why, I thought you probably were afraid to show your face. Since you prefer to shoot men in the back.
And who exactly?
Sergeant Pitt, Captain. Your rifle shot hit dead center, didn't it? Pity your second shot at a moving target didn't do me in. Maybe you ought to practice some more.
Did you see me do it?
It's obvious you hit Pitt, who was standing underneath you, before he could turn. Because the hole in his back's higher than the hole in his chest. That's why I took the rifle out of your saddle. To check to see if the barrel was still hot. And it was, Captain. So I simply made you give me the dispatch. Because you never meant to consign it.
It was wronger, Captain Lefebvre, to underestimate you, Hammond. But as long as you're here, you might as well tell us where you've hidden that dispatch.
Try to pan it out of the riverbed. Like a gold miner. You could even strike it big.
Who'd you give it to?
The riverbed. While I was in the water, it fell out of my shirt.
You may be telling the truth, Captain, but I don't think we should trust him. I know an old Indian trick to loosen his tongue, that it'd even make a dead man talk. Joe?
Yeah, Riggs?
Take this man to the rock quarry.
Come on.
Straight overhead before long, hotter and hotter, and it'll shine in your eyes till it roasts them. That sun'll make you as blind as a bat. If you can stand it, then maybe I'll believe your story about the riverbed. I'm in no hurry, Hammond. You stay with him. When he wants to talk, let me know.
Thank you.
Some horses fast. You've got to take it to the fort. I'll see if I can help poor Gary. Gary! Gary, it's me. It's Connie. Try and close your eyes now.
Okay.
Even if it hurts, or they'll never be cured, try, Gary.
Dispatch, Connie. Important information.
Don't worry. That old man you came with will take it. He's on his way.
I hope he can make it.
Yes.
Well, if it isn't Connie, what are you doing here?
This poor fella. He must have done something just terrible to deserve such treatment.
Answer my question.
I'm here at your invitation, Rex. You'll like it, Connie. King Rock's at Enchantin. Enchantin doesn't express it. To me.
Friend of yours?
Mine? No, but if I see anyone who's like that, I...
You'd feel like helping him out. Well, it's a pity your help can't do much good. Look at him. Blind as a bat. Well, now, we have lots of things to talk about. Isn't that what you came here for? You can cut him loose now. Come on, let's go.
Said we have lots to talk about.
Yeah? But why waste our time talking beforehand? Take them off. I said take them off. What's eating you? This is the first time, I suppose.
As a matter of fact, for the first time, you're right.
Anyway... It won't be the last time, honey. You can take Riggs' word for it.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Don't take so long. Enough of this comedy. That traitor I sent to roast outside had a dispatch for Fort Yuma. And you're the only one that he spoke to before we captured him. So I'm certain it was either you or him. You hid that dispatch someplace. Take your clothes and get dressed. You're coming with me to Red Mines.
Step right in, boy. Go on. Walk straight in front of you.
Gary. Gary. Rest a while. Sit down. Careful. Want some water? Huh? Drink it. Go on.
Come on, Connie. Hurry up.
Should we tie him up?
You're joking. This guy looks harmless to me.
If you behave yourself, I might even let you have him as he is. Watch him. I'll decide when I get back.
So long, cowboy.
Come on, let's go.
Time of night.
Oh, June, boss.
Lock this girl up in a mine shack, understand? And don't forget she's a prisoner.
Step this way. I said step this way. Inside.
All right, Carr.
Thank you.
One from you, Clyde?
I'm Pat. He's awake now.
Someone who's blind can be wide awake and still be unconscious.
I bet all this while he was a dreaming like a groundhog.
Did you dream all right? Of your Connie? You might as well dream, because you ain't going to see her again. You hear me, Rebel? You know where your sweetheart is now. She's someplace where she's kicking up her heels and singing a song just for Rick and no one else.
I think his son, he made him loco.
But his appetite, I'll bet you, is still working. Your supper's ready. Here, take the plate.
Go on, put out your hands.
Come on, I brought you your food. Good. Now, get the hell out of my way.
Pretending he's blind, the skunk.
Hold on, Joe. I say it was an accident. Two of you, take him away.
Let me out of here!
Hey, Clay.
Clem, you reckon a dang good spanking would calm her down a bit?
Why don't you try it?
Me, I'm too soft-hearted. I'd rather try and persuade her.
Would you care for coffee? We got a pot boiling.
Why, yes, thanks. I must admit, Newman, they're not altogether in agreement because of the risk. Decided to summon a staff meeting tomorrow at 10. I'd like you to show up after it starts. Mind how you handle that part you're playing. The game will depend on your acting.
I'll be first rate. Wait and see.
And better be.
Paul?
Who are you?
My name is Newman. I got to speak to Major Sanders.
Dismount and follow me. There's Mr. Newman here.
Have him join us.
Major will see you.
Morning, Major. Gentlemen.
What is it, Newman?
I've come from the fort, sir. I got you that plan you wanted.
Phenomenal. Well done, Newman.
For its defense, the fort can only muster 4 pieces of artillery and 450 rifles in all. In the last couple of weeks, almost half the garrison's been immobilized, too.
It's a chance we won't be given a second time, I'm sure. If we don't capture Fort Yuma the moment we attack it, I'll no longer be Major Sanders.
And that's not all. Inside the fort, there's a good friend of yours ready to give you a hand, gentlemen. When do you plan to attack, sir?
How much time before reinforcements can arrive?
I've been told the reinforcements should reach the fort in a few days, Major.
Day after tomorrow, sir, at daybreak, we will attack then. For the noble cause of the South.
Long live the Confederacy. Forever.
Forever.
Hey, Joe.
Now what?
Oh!
Let's do.
In Mexico, when there's two, there's always a third one.
You silly greaser, I'll make you the third one.
It was an accident.
He always raced with the horses. And do people like him get kicked in the head?
Who the devil kicked him then?
The evil eye. Murdoch was the first, and it looked like an accident. But then Joe, another case of bad luck, you say. The blind are bad luck. In Mexico, they say, beware the blind. Hey there! Via! Go away! Go on!
You've hit him enough. Stop it. I don't want to tangle with the rigs.
Hey, greaser. You taking a bath for once? Manuel. Manuel. Yuko. Yuko. Hey, come here, Yuko.
What is it?
It's the Mex. Look at him.
What's wrong?
Looks to me like we've had another one of them accidents.
His pistol's gone.
Behind your head.
He's an old friend of mine.
Brian!
Gary, you son of a gun. How are you?
Give me a drink.
Water. It's not a proper welcoming drink. But leastwise it's wet.
Huh? Couldn't taste better. I was hoping to run into one of you all, Brian. Where you bivouacked?
About half a mile away. You'll find plenty of friends up there, Gary.
I've got some big news for everyone. But I'd rather keep it from Major Sanders if I can. Is that possible?
I reckon. But what's the great secret?
The concerns of betrayal so filthy rotten it'll turn your stomach. Which way's the camp?
Follow me, Gary.
You! Hey, mister! Hey, mister! Wait for me! Hey, hold on a minute, will you? Wait for me!
Way I figure, we're right under the fort, men. Tomorrow we'll bust through to the gold. Good work. Okay, boys, have fun. I promise you some money in advance. Well, here it is.
Yeah, good news.
I'll pay the balance tomorrow morning.
Thanks a lot.
Put your tools away, boys, and I'll give each one his share.
Come on, boy, I know I
Accounts are all settled, including a bonus. Paid and ready cash.
Hammond, there are a few points in your story that aren't very clear.
I'll explain if I can, sir.
You said you were a prisoner at Camp Davis, I believe.
Yes, sir.
And you're the only one who's been released. At what price, Lieutenant Hammond?
The price is pretty high, Captain. Let's face it. It was to save my friends from being slaughtered by risking my own life to warn you all. What other purpose could I have had?
Saving Fort Yuma, for example?
You won't capture Yuma. You'll face 1,200 men and 16 cannon, and they know you're going to attack.
The famous dispatch, huh? The price of your liberty?
No. I'm saving your neck for you and saving all your men.
To me, you're a renegade, not a hero. Hammond, you say there's a doubt as to Major Sanders' loyalty? I'll investigate your charges because it's my duty. And I'll let you live till I prove your line about the Major. Give me your pistol.
Be ready to give it back tomorrow. When you finally realize that Major Sanders has run off the moment the attack starts.
I'll be ready. Because I'll shoot you if he doesn't with the same pistol.
Thank you.
exactly who gave you this dispatch?
It was Captain Gary Hammond, an officer of the 7th Missouri.
Why didn't he bring it?
Things went bad for him. Departments have worked for Riggs. Got their hands on him.
Gary Hammond, you said?
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't an officer of the 7th. He was a rebel lieutenant. However, you've come in time, and that's what counts. I'll only fire on those Southerners if they attack us first. Lieutenant, remove all the chests of gold and station 25 men in their place, all experienced. I want a staff meeting of all officers after the gold's removed.
I've got a question, Colonel. If I ask it, you won't be upset?
Of course not.
Yeah. If Hammond was a Confederate lieutenant, why did he risk being killed to fetch that dispatch?
Well, it was agreed that once he delivered the message, he would be free to contact the Southern guerrillas and warn them of the trap they were walking in. In that way, he could have avoided a useless massacre. It's a pity he wasn't able to accomplish the rest of his mission.
Why not let somebody else try it?
Who else would they trust?
One who's neither with the South nor the North, but a man who doesn't like killing people. Let me have a horse, Colonel. I'll do it.
Yeah, I know. I'll either be shot in a moment or two, or I'll be handed that pistol again.
You'd better exclude the second hypothesis. 16 pieces of artillery supporting 1,200 men. Where are they, Hammond?
Captain Taylor, sir. Captain Taylor, attack ahead of schedule. Orders the Major Sanders. The 1st Battalion's already in position, Captain.
And where is Sanders, Captain Taylor? You all have come to get butchered. And Sanders is the only sheep who's absent.
If that's a white flag, they're crazy. They can't try that trick on me. I'm colorblind.
Goldie.
Come back, I'll shoot.
Mission accomplished. Yes, sir, Lieutenant.
Prepare to attack.
You've seen the last of your friends.
You see that, Taylor? Now maybe you're convinced, Eddie. 16 pieces of artillery, plus all their rifles. But nobody will shoot unless you attack. That was also in the bargain.
Captain Taylor, sir!
Where's Major Sanders?
We thought we'd find him here, sir. If we attack, those cannon will massacre us all. I wonder where Sanders is.
I know where to find him.
I'll come with you, Gary.
No, leave it to me.
All right. But take my horse.
Your pistol, sir. Order the surrender.
I can't understand it. The cannons of the fort should have opened fire by this time.
Your heroic soldiers didn't run away, did they?
You impugning me. When I left, they were deployed as I ordered.
How can you be sure they'll follow orders? Unless you're there.
So I can be killed with him? I'm not that big a fool.
We got to make a decision. Immediately.
Why? Don't be hasty. It's possible there was a delay. Then we'll know whether to trust this tin soldier or not.
You may be a Yankee captain, Lefebvre, but I'll teach you the proper way to address a major...
Cut it out, you two. There are no majors or captains around here. We're all in this boat together. And it's sinking fast.
And you'll all drown together, Major Sanders.
I'm in the blood.
Where are you going? We're not finished yet.
Why?
Open the door and rescue the girl before she burns alive. Get away from the door, Connie! I shot it! I counted your shots, Hammond. Your last bullet made sure the girl stays alive, but it would cost you your life. And now recommend your soul to God if you still believe in him.
Thank you, Sergeant Pitt. Connie. 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 Connie.
I'd face hellfire till death do us part.